Bobby, you know, it's just impossible to lead the news this week without talking about the little wiener, the little Michael Allen weenie. Now, as a matter of fact, you know, I was listening. Well,
you're talking about my.
Michael Savage, the little.
Who is that baby? Who is the baby?
That's him in the background. Here's what he says. I can't believe. Now, this is his exact quote.
Well, let's tell what he did.
Wait a second. No, I think everybody knows this guy has been banned from the UK. The UK said he's so disgusting that you just can't even put him in. We don't want him in our country. So here's what listen to this. This is his quote.
By the way, Michael. Mike.
Yeah.
His stage name is Michael Savage. People may not know that his real name is Michael Allen Wiener. He took up like the name of a porn star for his radio show, which is a hate radio.
Well, now, first of all, what I love is this quote. You got to here it is. To link me up with skinheads who are killing people in Russia, to put me in the league with Hamas murderers who kill people. You know, on buses is defamation. This guy is so disgusting. Now, here's the short story on him. He's a guy, if you just go back and look at just a little bit of the history, he's the one that called Barbara Walters was an empty-minded slut that would peddle anything for ratings. I mean, when he talked about civil rights, he said it's a con racket that's used to exploit primarily heterosexual Christian white males' birthplace and steal from them what's their birthright and give it. In other words, this guy is out there crying like a baby. The little wiener is crying every day.
Well, here's the reason that the British decided to put him on a list of excluded people because of his unacceptable behavior in seeking to provoke others to commit serious criminal acts and fostering hatred, which might lead to inter-community violence, which is true. He hates gay people. He hates minorities. He hates Islamic people, Muslims. And he has commented in a derogatory way about women who have been raped and about children who have autism.
Yeah, what did he say? What was his take on the autism? He said they're just brat kids, that nothing's wrong with them. They're just brats.
Yeah, and they should be. They should. He says. He says a brat who hasn't been told to cut the act out.
Jeez. Well, now if you remember back in 2003, he's also the guy that there was a caller that identified himself as gay called into a show, and he said that he hoped that the caller would die of AIDS. He's also the same guy that said we need to burn the Mexican flag in opposition to illegal immigrants. Isn't the real question here? I mean, really, isn't the real question what kind of freak listens to this guy? I mean, that's the bigger question to me. You're sitting listening to the little wiener. Now, first of all, Bobby, this guy, you know, has got to have a past where, you know, he's probably had the hell beat out of him just about, you know, every day growing up, because he's grown up with a name named Michael Wiener. And so he changes his name. This is a guy who's been, you know, that he's been beat on day after day. He's got so much hate in him that it all comes out on his radio show. And what about these people say, yeah, this is what I want to listen to. I want to listen to this freak.
Well, getting to another story involving a right-wing hate monger, Dick Cheney.
Yeah. God, there's a lot of stories on Dick this week. Didn't he just move it? Is he a neighbor now? Is he a neighbor?
Yeah, he actually moved into the house. The house that he moved into right next to my mother's house, Hickory Hill, McLean, Virginia. And actually, the house he moved into is the neighbor of the house. I don't know if you remember this guy, Edwin Wilson, who was this CIA spy during the 1970s and 1980s.
I don't remember him, no.
And he went to Libya. He was sent by the CIA to Libya. He had his own kind of outsourced company that smuggled arms. And he was supposed to keep his eye on the Jackal, on Carlos the Jackal. But instead, he opened up a company there and recruited a bunch of Green Berets and began training Libyans in terrorism and smuggling arms to Libya. And one of the people he trained was actually the guy who blew up the 747 over Lockerbie, Scotland. Wilson ultimately was arrested, served, I think, 27 years in prison, and then was released because he was able to prove that everything he had done had been sanctioned by the CIA. Well, when they captured him, he actually fled to Libya. They raided his house, which is right next to the Cheney house, and he had a hidden bunker in it that was filled with, like, bazookas and mortars and all kinds of arms. So it's a good place to Cheney, because if he, you know, he can keep his gun collection over there. But anyway, my daughter, it was Mother's Day this weekend, as you know. I hope you remembered.
I did.
I hope you gave Terry some flowers.
Vacuum cleaner, you know? Just kidding, obviously. Yeah.
Right, I gave Mary a bowling ball with my initials on it. Just like
Homer Simpson. I'd get a bowling ball upside the head if I gave Terry a vacuum cleaner. But anyway, go ahead. I know this is going to be a good story.
So anyway, my daughter went home to visit her grandmother for Mother's Day, and she's 13, and she was with her 10-year-old cousin, and they went over to Dick Cheney's house, and I guess they were just messing around, and they began buzzing the intercom and asking if Dick was home, and somebody answered, they assumed was a security guard.
Is Dick home?
And they asked him, would he like some cupcakes, because they had made some cupcakes, and he said, or a cookie. He said he'd prefer a cookie. So they went back to the house, my grandmother's house, and they got some cupcakes and cookies, and they brought it over there. And they rang again, and actually Dick Cheney came out on the yard. And he had his little 5-year-old grandchild with him. And he said to them, where are you girls from? And there was 4 of them there in their bathing suits. And they said, we're from New York. And he said, well, what are you doing here? And they said, we're visiting our grandmother. And he said, where does she live? And they pointed to our house, Hickory Hill. And he said, oh, there are Kennedys. And Kira said his nostrils flared.
He wouldn't eat the... Well, look, you know, I got to tell you something. Right now, it's so obvious. This guy is...
But I have to say, he was very, very, very amiable. And the Cheney grandchildren, my mother told me, came over to her house. My mother is very opposed to that kind of neighborliness because she holds a grudge against political stuff. She hates torture. She hates Guantanamo, and she, you know, she'll hold it against people to the day they die.
Well,
so she would not have done it, but he very graciously sent his grandchildren over the following day with a cake. My mother.
Look, I'm going to turn all that around because I'm going to tell the other side. Let me tell not the warm and fuzzy side. We'll take a break. I'll come back with the other Cheney stories. Doesn't involve cupcake. Doesn't involve cake. It involves the real ugly Dick Cheney. We'll be right back.